Hi guys, Sci-Fi Recapped here. Before we start, warning, spoilers ahead. Today, I'm going to explain a 2017 science fiction live action and fantasy movie called A Djinn, or Demi-Human. The movie starts with an introduction to a djinn. A djinn are a new breed of humans who cannot die. No matter how badly they're injured, they only die temporarily and come back to life. 26 years ago, the first a djinn was discovered in South Africa. So far, 46 a djinn have been identified in the world. A few days ago, a man named Ki Nagai accidentally got hit by a truck and died. Surprisingly, he came back to life with his injury all gone, thus the government named him as the third a djinn. The government immediately takes Nagai under their protection, but it turns out the government is running an experiment on the captured a djinn. The head of the research lab, Yutosaki, shows the ongoing research to the government. Turns out Nagai doesn't know that he is in a djinn. Before the accident happened, he was living a normal life as a university hospital intern in Tokyo. Suddenly, the lab got breached by terrorists, Sato and Tanaka, who knows Tosaki and claims that he's come to take away Nagai. The guards immediately come to stop them. The guards attack Sato with a tranquilizer and manage to hit him on the hand. Unexpectedly, he cuts his hand and continues to fight. Not long after, he got shot again on his arm, but this time, he shot himself to death. Turns out Sato's in a djinn as he comes back to life again, now with a new hand. A few moments later, Sato frees Nagai and continues to kill the researcher. After that, he gives his gun to Nagai and tells him to kill the remaining researcher. Surprisingly, Nagai rejects him, and then Sato shows him an example. Because of this, Nagai shoots him and runs away with the rest of the survivors as Sato comes back to life again. Sato eventually manages to catch up to them, and now he summons a creature called Black Ghost. Sato attacks them with the creature, but suddenly, Nagai unconsciously summons his Black Ghosts to defend them from the attacks. Both of the creatures clash, and Nagai uses the opportunity to run away. Sato eventually manages to stop him, but this time Nagai uses his creature to kill Sato and manages to run away this time. The dusk is coming, and the reporters arrive at the location. Turns out Sato has planned this. He and Tanaka head to the reporters' location, and they spill the information about the experiment that has been done to the a djinn. Sato reveals himself to the public that he is an a djinn and claims that he saves the second a djinn, Tanaka, from the government. They even upload a recording of Tanaka being experimented on the internet. After that, Sato demands for civil rights for a djinn and a special area for a djinn to live in. The next day, Nagai meets an old woman who invites him to her house. He accepts the offer and rests up there. In the hospital, a guard named Izumi asks Nagai's sister, Eriko, for his whereabouts. Suddenly, Izumi got attacked by Tanaka's black ghost that has invisibility power. Turns out Tanaka is outside the hospital, and then he uses the creature to capture Eriko so that they can lure Nagai. Surprisingly, Izumi is in a djinn and immediately attacks Tanaka's creature. Because his creature is weaker when he is far away, he comes into the hospital. Not long after, Tanaka arrives, but Eriko is already surrounded by many people, so he decides to go back to Sato. In a conference, Tosaki replies back to Sato. He rejects their statement and also claims that the recording is fabricated. Meanwhile, Nagai is helping the old woman. Not long after, he hears the news about her sister being attacked. Because of this, he immediately goes to the hospital. There, he meets Eriko on the roof. He tells Eriko that she is not safe there, so he decides to bring her to the old woman's place. The next day, he trains himself and tries to control the creature that he has. Meanwhile, Sato responds to the government and public. He says that they decide to resort to force and will destroy the Ministry of Health that runs the research lab. He tells the upcoming date and also invites the a djinn that's still in hiding to fight with them. On the announced day, the police were seen to guard the area. The minister is inside the building and says that nothing will happen. Suddenly, a plane is falling and crashes into the building. Turns out, Sato is inside the plane as Tanaka brings his equipment by using a drone. Some people also came to support Sato from the announcement. Not long after, Sato got surrounded by the police forces. He gets shot and dies, but the police shoot at him even before he comes back so that Sato can't resurrect. Tanaka then shoots them with a sniper rifle, allowing Sato to break free. Sato eventually manages to win against all of the police by using his Ajin power. After that, he demands the government to surrender Tokyo in 20 days, or else they will spray the whole Tokyo with AJVX gas, the most efficient way to kill a large quantity of people. Meanwhile, Negai and his sister run from the old woman's house because the villagers notice that Negai isn't a jin. A few days later, Tosaki contacts Sato and offers him North Hokkaido. But because he demands Tokyo, he rejects the offer. On his way home, Tosaki notices that Negai has been waiting for him. Negai offers Tosaki his help to prevent Sato's attack, but in return, the government must take his sister under government protection and change his identity. Tosaki accepts the offer, and then they start to plan their strategy. On the other side, Sato and his men prepare for the attacks. It turns out Tanaka spent 2 years as a guinea pig, and Sato spent 20 years as a guinea pig. That's the reason they hate the humans so much. On the day of the attacks, Sato begins the attack with one of Sato's men infiltrates the building where the AJCV is. He manages to hack into the government system. Tanaka and the rest then boldly barge in and manages to run into the emergency exit to go up where the gas is located. Not long after, Tosaki manages to catch the hacker. Tanaka reaches the room where the gas is located. Suddenly, black mist surrounds them from the vent. Turns out, the black mist is produced by Negai. Because of this black mist, they can't see very well since it can only be seen by another Ajin. With this opportunity, the police manage to tranquilize Tanaka and the rest of them. Meanwhile, Tanaka arrives at a wood disposal place. There, he gets in a wood chipper and unexpectedly, he resurrects to the building. Turns out, he cut his hand beforehand and Tanaka brought his hand with him. Shocked by this, Negai and the police use the same tactic again and he gets shot by the tranquilizer. When someone approaches him, he wakes up and turns out he uses his creature to shield him. He then kills the rest of the guard. After that, he frees the captured Tanaka. They then take the AJVC gas. Sato then goes to the top of the building and he informs Negai to come there as well. Without a doubt, he goes to the top and manages to take away the gas. Then, both of them and both of their creatures battle each other. On the other side, Tosaki meets Tanaka and he immediately attacks Tosaki with his creature. Suddenly, Izumi comes and helps Tosaki from being killed. Their creature then battles each other, and both of the owners also get into a fist fight. Tanaka manages to corner Izumi, while suddenly Tosaki comes and stabs him with a tranquilizer. Because of this, they manage to win against Tanaka as he passes out from the tranquilizer. Going back to Negai and Sato, the epic battle goes on. Sato is also very impressed with him, since his growth is so fast in just a few weeks. Negai manages to shoot him with a tranquilizer, but with the exchange of one of his hands. Sato passes out, but sadly his creature is not, and immediately kills Sato, and then he comes back again. When Sato's about to kill Negai, suddenly a group of police come in from the roof and attack Sato with a taser gun. Negai then holds Sato, and both of them are frozen by the police. The police then destroy both of them and collect the body parts and make them unable to regenerate. At the end of the movie, Tosaki breaks his promise to Negai because of his higher-up's demands to. Suddenly, Negai's hand that got cut off from before begins to regenerate and brings Negai back to life again. After that, he goes out from the top of the building and runs away. Subscribe to watch more videos like this, turn on notifications, and leave a like to help the channel out. Thank you for watching.